Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today we are going to review two new models released from Microsoft very recently. They are two multimodal models, which this means that you can send in your instruction in your prompt text plus images. And well, they are, in my opinion, quite interesting models, as the size is really small and they are performing really, really well. There are two different approaches. The FI3 is one of the models that we already review, but only the text version. We create a couple of videos already on the channel that you can take a look. One in a series of the videos I'm doing regarding or evaluating different models versus the chain of truth dataset or chain of truth tags, which is one of the most difficult for LLMs to solve. And the Florence Two is what they nowadays named multi-tax vision models. So two different, they are both are multimodal. So again, both of them accept text and images and produce only text. So they are obviously mix input output only text. So let's start. I have prepared, as usual, two notebooks, one with the Vision 3 Vision and the other one with Florence. So here I pass you some of the documents, relevant documents. There is very, very good documented repository and documentation about FI. Again, there is four different versions, flavors of the FI. The mini is the one I've been doing the test majoritarily, the 3.8 billions of parameters model. Then there is the Vision. This is the multimodal version, and then we have the small and the medium. The benchmark claim to be really, really good. For example, take a look some of the numbers in comparison, even with a model with 700 billions of parameters, probably more, so 200 times or 280 times bigger than the FI3 small. And the numbers here, let me check where we had chain of truth: 89.6, 78.1. And you have here Llama 3, 8 billions. And Mistral 7 billions, the 8, the Gemma bit 59. So the numbers are really, really good for a model with such size. So this time you are comparing with models that are 2 times bigger, and with GPT 3.5 Turbo, which is practically 200 times bigger. In honor to the truth, we had to say that at the time that GPT 3.5 Turbo was trained, there was not the same techniques now available to train the models, also not the hardware, and many things that now the new models take advance, like flash attention, heads with flash attention, new techniques as well on the GPUs, which makes everything faster. And also, at the time that GPT 3.5 Turbo, well, no, only didn't exist quantization for int or a int, these kind of things that now we believe that they are quite how to say normal, but in fact, but they were there just months ago. But as you probably know, things here in LLMs are running extraordinarily fast. So what happened, month by month, you see changes, very big changes, new models, more powerful, smaller, and even powerful than others. Yeah, you can see here. So listen, they are check the medium. They are doing comparison with Gemini and with Claude 3. So, and they are beating these models. So the models in some of the tags, probably not in all the tags, are beating, and the models are really for that size, is really impressive what they are doing with this. And again, they are taking advantage of the new techniques in the transformer architecture. And this is, and also the as they claim on the paper. I think the paper is that one. So they say that they are using a specific data sets for both, no? For Florence and also for V3. They have been used a new data set prepared for that, and also lesson learned from the V2, the antecessor of this model. And take a look to the document. It's quite interesting just to, well, to get an understanding. Some of this stuff is pretty technique, very some of the stuff even I didn't hear many things that are really latest state-of-the-art techniques. But yeah, here you have all the documentation. We are going to see now how it works with some examples. One of the good things as well, the model have a quantified collections, if I'm not wrong here. Let me check if we have, where we have, sorry, let me find out where I had all the, here, if I'm not wrong, exactly. So we had the collection of the V3, we had the text, the instruct versions with different sizes, with different context window, 4K and 128K from the same size. And then we had the visions, we had ONX version and also GGUF from ONNX from CUDA and CPU. I want to, and also the instruction you had in there, direct ML. I create a video days ago there where I make comparison with this model with the C or with the CPU, the CUDA, and also the a version just log it into MLflow server with the BrainFlow 16 direct ML with a GPU in Windows, also performing really good. And as I said, we had different versions in the format on ONNX, and well, I want to do a video testing the vision in this format because, well, just to the idea, my idea is to be able to serialize or to log this model in an MLflow server and then on reuse it in any other environment. When once I have it ready, I will how to say, create a video and share with the community. Okay, let's move with that. We install the libraries we need the flash attention library. Not the all GPUs are going to take advantage of this library, so the oldest one it will not work, and maybe even the output is not very accurate what you get because yeah, they are, as I said, they are taking advantage of the new technologies, the new infrastructure, and yeah, in an L4 is working, in a T4 is working as well, in a E100 in Colab Pro is working. I didn't try in my computer. I try in my computer with Direct ML, with the Microsoft library, Direct ML, and it works, and the output was really promising. I wouldn't say that are done faster than working in an NVIDIA, but well, my GPU is a GTX Force 1650 with 4 GB. So in a local environment, I think you need to have one of the latest one. Probably my one is 2 or 3 years older, and this technology I don't think that is incorporated on this GPU. But in any case, with TAR-HTML works, I could load the V3 Mini and work with that in ONX format with 4 bytes quantization. So the model is practically 1.2 gigabytes of the memory, so it switch in my GPU, and it works. Obviously the time with a poor processor graphics processor that probably my GPU has, it was not spectacular, but it works. And the new as well, that this TAR-HTML is something that you had already in Windows 11, Windows Server, Windows 10, and you don't need to install any library, any CUDA toolkit, nothing. You can work with in a Windows environment, which is really an advantage. Okay, we import the libraries, we download the model in BrainFlow 16. We load it. Now, instead to use the tokenizer, we use autoprocessor, which is a class which allow us to tokenize not only the text, also the image as well. We create here just a helper to visualize the images. We create the prompt. The prompts are a little bit specific. You need to read the documentation to create the prompts for the Phi series. And here you have the prompt. We open this image and we tokenize or process the prompt, which is a combination of text and image, and as usual we return tensors, PyTorch tensors, and we move it to the CUDA device. So we visualize the image. The image is a plot of the NVIDIA stock, and I'm asking to introduce me the stock and also explain me the plot, no? So here I just checking how long it takes, 18 seconds to process this image. We generate, we use this method is quite, you probably are familiar with that because it's coming from this class, AutoModel for Causal LM. This is the one that we use usually in generative tags. And here just produce 1000 new tokens and the NOT sequence tokens. And we basically, the output is finally the code with our processor. And then you can check the response, quite impressive for a model with such size. And you can take a look later. Again, I will upload the notebooks to the repo. You can download it and check in your local environment. Again, in a collab, no problem. It works really, really good. Now I make here some OCR as well. It's just an image and extract the text. It's the front of a book. And then check here, we had even handwriting and the title of the book. Well, the prompt was, sorry, help me to get the title of the title and the author information of this book, and it was perfect. Here I use one of the example I use for testing some other models, and also in the series I did for OCR, also available on the channel. You can take a look where I test TCRR and some other technologies, Azure OCR, AWS, Strat, and Google Vision as well. And then I always test with some images like that. Just I wanted to test if I can replace some of the models I had in production with Tesseract with some of the new LLMs. So the output of this test is promising in terms of quality, but in terms of times it's not really, for now, really promising. In my production environment I'm using Tesseract version, which is essentially working on C with a wrapper on Python. You had the video on the channel, how it is set up, and this image takes 1 second to, no, sorry, 3 seconds, almost 4, in being extracted. The problem is not this, it's just, how to say, automatizing. Maybe automatizing this, if you can send, like happens with, for example, with Gemini or GPT-4o, you can send multiple images and do the extraction, but if you have to do one by one, it's quite slow. But in any case, the output is really promising. You can say the quality is really good, extract the text really precisely. And well, the only thing that is the time, maybe in a small text like this, you for example have to extract the data from a identification. Yeah, you can run this in a mobile device, because they claim to be able to run these models in tables, no, tablets, and also in smartphones. So it's something that I want to try as well. How is working with the smaller versions, especially the Vision One, because it can solve some of the use cases I'm working on. And the last example is just comparing two images. This is everything from the documentation of the Microsoft. Then two images here. You can send a list of images, is what I say now. Instead to here, we do a comparison of the two images, but we can send just, okay, extract the text of the images. And well, it may work. This essentially, this CV is 3 pages. I can make a try as well and see how long it takes. No, here, comparing these two images and providing a response in natural language is really 10 seconds. These two images of the Arsenal Football Club. One is presenting here what they won, the prizes, and here is celebrating the champions, I suppose. I'm not very big football fan. But well, it's again, at the end is what the model described, no, which is really, really, really good. Eh? It's at least make a comparison, so it understood clearly that what we had in these two images, and the it makes a very good job. Eh? And again, consider the size of the model is really, really small, 4.8 billion parameters, which is nano for what we just to work, and we cannot compare this with the Vision, with Gemini 1.5 Pro, because well, the context window, well, is 8 times bigger, no, 8 times, no, 16 times bigger in Gemini, 2 million tokens, which is a lot. And then well, here again, I want to try with more images and see what happened, and it checking the time, because it's true that when you have, for example, a PDF with multiple images, it's obviously taking 3-4 seconds per page, and then at the end it's accumulative. So if once we have the images in memory, we don't have to say, we avoid the penalization to have to say read a new image, and because the process I had is I take a document, I extract the images from that document, it is a PDF, a Word, a PPT, whatever, an HTML which contain something that you need to extract the text. So every image later on is processed, and depending on the format of the image, takes in between some images, also obviously depending on the quality or on the size. Quality means size in the image. It will take more or less time, no? But in between the minimum 2 seconds up to 4, some cases with the PNGs takes a little bit longer. But yeah, it Every image, just imagine you have a document with 10 pages, it could take between 40 to 50 seconds. I will check how it takes it, and even it is possible to send 4, 5, 6, 7 pages at the same time in the same input and check how long it takes. It is okay. I will create just a short video just to show the outputs. Probably at the same time I prepare a video that I want to do with these versions that are quantized. No? We had the vision in format, if I'm not wrong, 4 integer, instruct CUDA model. Let me check. Yeah, we had the 128. But where I found that we have the model. No. So, let me 1 second. We had, it's written down here in the documentation. We had a model in version ONNX. We had versions of floating point 16 and integer 4 bytes. So I want to test with this and check the quality of the OCR extraction and also sending multiple pages because we had a long context window here, 128K, which is okay. It's to at least 10 pages is really enough. No? I will check it and depending how it works, and also again, I want to test these versions with the quantization and see if they keep the quality of the extraction. Okay, let's move to the Florence. Florence is another, let me prepare the video, the notebook, and I will be back in 2 seconds. Okay, here we are. So Florence. Florence is also a new model recently released from Microsoft. It's what they name multi-task vision model. It's as well a multimodal model. It's the approach is slightly different because here you send you can only send some instructions to the model and it will do something. You send instructions in text and you can also send some free text just to, for example, localize this car or localize or how to say, create a bounding box around the car or around the cycler. These kind of things we will see now. So the approach is slightly different, but one of the good things we have is the size. The size, take a look, the base model is 232 millions model and the large is 771, and the quality you will see now is impressive. Here I just also had the paper here in the, you can take a look, really interesting again, really is just for, in my case, it's just many things I don't understand and I had to be honest, many things that they describe and all these new techniques that they are using are some of them quite, you need to be in this world of researching to understand these new techniques, but well, you probably, like in my case, I get the concept, the general concept. I don't go to the details because especially when they discuss some of the mathematical formulations. In this case, they are not very heavy, but some cases are they are a lot, very, very complex to understand all the mathematical reasoning. But in any case, the model is quite well prepared. And you can take a look as well the performance and all the stuff and what is possible to do with the model. That's something that we will do now. Okay, we install also I pass you here the reference to the what we had, the collection in Hugging Face. We had the foundation models, large and base, and this is fine-tuned with a dataset of 126 millions to do what is entitled to do the model. 5.4 billion of annotation. This is a dataset that Microsoft create to specifically train this series of models. Okay, let's move. We install the libraries. Don't worry, I later, as I said, I will upload the notebooks. We here essentially download the model again with the autoprocessor, our tokenizer, the same function. Here we just take an image, it's a car, a blue car, and now here essentially you can see here there is some tags with there are fixed labels. There is a number, probably like 20 different tags. Not 15 different tags, and then on some of the tags you can also send some free text, just for example to localize the window or to mark signal or make the contour of the car. I will show you later on, and then on the same as we did with the processor, we send the prompt. The prompt is the in some cases it's only the label or the tags, and that is, and the image in pixels. We use the same generate, this is standard already, and then on we decode the text, and here take a look to what we are generating. Here we input the text, so the visual embeddings, and then on the text and location embeddings. This is what is producing our tokenizer, and then entering the encoder decoder, and our output is text plus location of boxes or objects in of the image. It's what they say here, multi-tax vision model. Different tags, segmentation, labeling, tagging, etc. So here we are going to do to test. You see here the prompts are instructions, very concise instructions, caption, detailed caption. You see here more detailed caption. And yeah, the model is here now object detection. Another, this is, they don't need that, they don't accept additional if so the model understand the tags, and even if you send additional text, it's not gonna take care of that. So here in object description, you is produce and also the model, depending on the instruction, it produce B boxes or not. So when it produces B boxes, bounding boxes, also produce labels, as in this case. Now we plot the image with the bounding boxes, and here we detect the door, the wheel, and the car. Here there is another label, there's region caption. It's just detecting what you had in the forefront, in the front of the image. It's not it doesn't take care of the background. It's just to capture the main objects on the image without the landscape or without the background of the image. Region proposal, this is just to enumerate the object that the model to see the TED. You see even here the hand, the handler. So this is I don't know what is the name in English, sorry. The window here, also the light, the two wheels, etc. Here now there is other, here you can send this caption to phrase grounding. You can send a sentence, and in this case it will detect the main objects of your sentence. Here is a green car parked in front of a yellow building, so there is a building and a car, and then it's exactly what is detecting, no? The main objects of your description. Here you just want to detect one object, a green car. Take a look here as well, it's returning V-boxers or polygons. Here what we are gonna do is just create the shape or the contour of the object with this referring expression segmentation. Here we receive a polygon. For those that are working on GIS, this will be very pretty, how to say, familiar to you, because yeah, it's what usually you receive when you want to create a shape in a map. You receive a polygon. Polygon, which is a sequence of points in your map, and you later you can draw a line following from coordinate to coordinate. This is exactly the same. And here we just create a method, and you can see here we are creating the shape of the car, and later filling with if you just pass here false, which, it will just create the contour, the yellow line. These points that you see here are this yellow contour. And when you fill it, what is this logic here is doing is filling what is inside the contour. Region to segmentation, just you can also send the points with this nomenclature, and it will draw the region that you are specifying in this input. We had open vocabulary. You want to just how to say extract in a bounding box of an object. Here the green car, here the door, here and here a window, and then here you can see. So the model is pretty good. Even detect the windows of the car, windows of the here in the wall on the house, and windows on the car. And here there is two additional text region to description, which is just giving you what you had in this location, in this bounding box. You had the car, and here which category of object you have in the same location. It's categorized as car. Now we look at the OCR. OCR, which pass this image, is as well for the sample, is doing a good job. Some small mistakes, like here, don't respect the spaces, but well, it can be acceptable. Here as well is creating the bounding boxes around the text. And here I use the same image I used before with the CV, and well, slightly worse than the phi, but okay, it's a smaller model with less parameters, so you should expect a little bit less quality. And it's true, you can check here. So it's joining two different words multiple times, something that the phi didn't do it. Phi in that aspect behaved much better. And well, that's all. I get the end very quickly. So here we had two new models, which are really, really good in my opinion. Small, so they claim to be running in small devices, in cheap infrastructure, which is one of the objectives that many providers like Microsoft or even, well, also Anthropic or Google, even OpenAI are testing, creating the mini GPT-4, and then some models which are smaller but keeping as much quality as possible, just to be able to run in small devices or in as plugins in notebooks or in browsers, in something that you can run in a cheap infrastructure and have a kind of intelligent and at least keeping the quality and in a good term. No? And these are two examples of models which are, in my opinion, performing really well. The benchmarks are in both cases impressive, especially phi. I really impressed with the model. This is pretty simple model, very small, but it's doing really good job. You can test with your own images and tell us how do you find it, make a comment, and you can share with the rest what do you think about these models. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much for watching the video up to this point. I hope that you like it and you enjoy it with the content and you find it useful for your job or your training or whatever reason you are watching this video. And if so, give me a like, subscribe to the channel if you didn't do before, and share with your colleagues and friends, make comments and everything that you can. It's free to promote the channel in YouTube. Thank you very much. See you soon.